Any soldier will tell you they take their lives in their hands when they leave base. It's a disturbing yet realistic assessment of the state of affairs of the British military in Basra, and has been for some time. But have things deteriorated to such a degree that British forces are now under siege? Private Craig Barber died in Iraq this week, killed by a single shot through a crack in the driver's hatch of his Warrior armoured fighting vehicle. He was one of four soldiers who've lost their lives in the last 3 days out on patrol in Basra. Between April and July, 30 British soldiers have died in Iraq, the deadliest period since the spring invasion of 2003. It brings the total number of troops killed to 168. The days of patrolling the streets in berets have long gone. Instead, helicopters blaze flares into the night sky to ward off insurgent missiles. So great is the risk of attack, almost all travel between bases is by air and at night. Yet the military deny their strategy is failing. Shaiba Logistics Base on the outskirts of Basra city was handed over to the Iraqi army in April, part of the so-called drawdown of British forces, which is scheduled to see the number of troops reduced to 5,000 by the end of the year. But increasingly there's a view that the presence of troops is doing more harm than good.
They are effectively under siege. They go out on patrol, of course, but they're subject to attacks then. I mean, they're attacks on a very frequent basis. Simply this week, some of those attacks have unfortunately been fatal for the British forces involved. Control of Basra and the surrounding area has been in the hands of the various local groups for some time, and I think the British military are aware they can do little more.
America, though, has repeated its stance that cutting and running from Iraq is not an option.
Does it matter whether or not we stay long enough for an ally in this war against radicals and extremists to emerge? And my answer is it does matter. Long-term consequences will face our country if we leave before the job is done.
But in the long term, it seems Britain sees its place in Iraq as very different to America's, with a significant troop withdrawal sooner rather than later looking increasingly likely.